get in your like this, yeah. And you push off, and then I'll show you how to stop.
Okay,
just go
show me.
You must find a wall to do this, though.
All this and more on Mid-Morning LA.
How do you turn around once you do this?
I rode my bicycle past your window last night. I roller skated to your door at daylight. It almost seems like you're avoiding me. I'm okay alone, but you got something I need. Well, I got a brand new pair of roller skates. You got a brand new key. I think that we should get together and try them out to see. I've been looking around a while. You got something for me. Oh, I got a brand new pair of roller skates. You got a brand new key.
Well,
you don't need keys with these.
You don't?
No, you don't. You don't use keys anymore, do you? Roller keys.
That's now what Allison wants for Christmas. Skates with stoppers, but they're like $30 or $40, and if you buy it for a six-year-old, then the next year she won't be able to wear them. It's crazy.
That's a good question to ask Mike a little bit later.
Hey,
what do you do for kids? Can you get expandable skates that sort of grow with a kid?
That's a great idea. Are you all on the Christmas?
There we go. Hello, Mike. How you doing?
How are you, Bob?
This is Mike Fleming, co-owner of Skateland with his brother Dave, and was voted as the 1980 Roller Rink Operator of the Year and the former Dance Champion of the World on roller skates.
Not of the world, of the United States, but that's good enough for me.
Who's the lady that you skated with?
That's with my wife Darcy.
Oh, is that how you met?
That's how we met. Matter of fact, my brother met his wife skating, my dad met my mom skating.
Oh,
it's kind of a whole skating
something
family.
Something in the skates, I think, that does something.
Yeah, I think it is.
Christmas time. You told me that this particular Christmas, last Christmas and the one before that, since the roller skating boom has come about, that millions and millions of pairs of skates will be sold, and not mm-hmm. too many people really know how to select skates.
Right. Last year, there were almost 10 million skates sold. It's a lot of skates. A lot of people skating.
What about the parents, like Meredith was talking a while ago, getting a pair of skates for her kid? She's very tiny right now, and she needs a skate about, where's that little bitty skate?
Maybe, there we go.
Maybe this is an Allison skate right here.
Yeah, right.
For about a week. And then the kid goes, what do you do?
Right, well, these particular skates are rental skates. And what we usually recommend at our place is that parents that have very small children, let's say 2, 3, 4, 5 years old, usually come into the rinks to rent skates, and when the skater or the child becomes proficient, then they can start looking at a skate. Now, this particular skate, if a parent were to go and buy it, would run probably about $65. Yeah, quite a bit.
It lasts for how long?
Probably 2 weeks, if it's like my son, about 2 weeks. But I must say that most of the skating rinks that sell skates, they will usually have large plates put on the bottom of the skates. For example, this plate, you can see it goes almost all the way to the end, that when the child grows out, you can usually get one full size larger on that same plate. So you're able to keep the skate for another size, and then after that is the next thing, trade-in. This is one of the things I think
you really can do some trade-in?
Yeah, I think the people don't realize this, and they think, gee, I go to a department store, whatever, I buy a pair of skates, and then wham, the kid grows out of them. What do I do with this pair of skates? Put them in the newspaper, whatever. But skating centers all through the United States, most of them have trade-in programs, and that's one of the things they should ask, so that you can bring that skate back and get another pair.
What about the old type of skates? Now, not this particular one. We'll talk about this one in a second. But what weird skate, folks. What about the old type that you can just lock on or have the clamps around your shoes? Aren't those safe enough? And as your child grows, then you could get into these better skates?
A lot of those aren't being made anymore. With the developments of polyurethane and plastics, we've found that it's a much, much safer wheel to use. And many of the skates, as we remember, have metal wheels. Mm. And those are very, very dangerous for outdoor skating.
So these plastic, what happened to the other wheels? The plastic are better. Well, take a look at this. This is the weirdest skate I've ever seen. Isn't this a bit dangerous to use something like
right,
this?
Right, that came from Japan, and it's not the greatest for the ankles, because as you can see, there's no ankle support there at all. whatever kind of shoes you happen to be wearing at the time, or even barefooted. But you have to have some pretty strong feet to be able to skate on these things.
Sort of an ice skate with a wide blade or something.
Sure.
Is it better to go out and, rather than picking a pair of skates when you don't really know that much about selecting them, is it better to go out and buy the bottom and then buy the wheels and then buy the boot to put on it?
Well, a lot of people do it that way. Generally, I think the thing people should look for now, especially with Christmas coming up, are entire packages. Now, many of the skate manufacturers are discounting certain packages. You'll save a lot of money if you buy this particular package. Once you start separating, it's like buying a car. I'll have these seats and these windows and these tires. You're going to
add
them.
But that's not where you start.
Oh,
you don't start like that. You just go in and how do you pick your first pair of skates? And most people are going to look at a skate like this and say, boy, that is cute. Is that the kind of skate to get?
Right. Well, this is, it's kind of interesting you picked this skate up, because the biggest question we get at our rink is, are these tennis shoe skates safe?
Are these tennis shoe skates safe? I can't talk today. There's garbage snappers in your hama hama hama?
That's for sure.
Okay.
There are a lot of people, people see this when the outdoor boom hit. This is the skate that appeared.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, it wasn't this skate, it was this skate. This skate is manufactured by the Sure Grip Skate Company.
Mm-hmm.
This was the first tennis shoe skate to ever be made, and it was made the right way. They had a lot of skating experts come in. They had talked to a lot of shoe companies, and this particular shoe has a lot of support in it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you say, well, what about the ankle? Well,
I was fixing to show you the difference
right.
in the two skates. Like, this one goes up here and gives you all kinds of ankle support. You're tied up to the top.
Yeah, you should have fairly strong ankles if you're going to skate in this. But I think more importantly is to check the skate. For example, this one here, you can see it's you can squeeze this up here.
You know that you don't have
very
any
flimsy.
So as much care as a person gives a running shoe or a basketball shoe or something like that, you should really look for all the supports and things that you particularly need. There's all kinds of stops to put on the front of a skate, all kinds of wheels to go to, different types of skate. ski skate. I tell you what, we'll take a break and come back and talk about more types of skate. Ski skate?
Ski skate. Great.
We'll be
great
back
for
in
those
a second.
Mountains. Going down.
I rode my bicycle.
The rink operators of 1980. That's great. Congratulations.
Thank you.
A few safety things real quick. On the fronts of skates, they all have something to stop, and you need rubber on the front of it, right?
Right, toe stop, right. And this is one of the things that people should look for. In bargain skates, you're going to find that that the toe stop is not rubber. You're going to find that it's plastic.
Uh-huh.
And those are pretty dangerous because, especially when the kids start using them outside, they hit that sidewalk and the toe stop will actually begin to disintegrate. It breaks apart in pieces.
So it doesn't stop you at all?
No, it doesn't stop hardly at all.
We're going to do a little demonstration in just a second of how to stop, seriously, the safety ways to do it and everything like that. But you're talking of getting out on the streets. Now, there's a wheel for inside a rink. There's a wheel for outside the rink. How do you know what to get?
Right. Well, the wheels are measured by a scale called durometer scale. And what the people should look for, basically, this is what I tell everyone, when you're going to buy, let's say, an outdoor pair of skates, you want to have a softer wheel. The reason for that, of course, is when you hit those cracks and crevices and that for outdoor skating, you want that wheel to be able to take it and bounce over it smoothly.
You showed me the bounce test. When we go down here, which two do you want to do the bounce test
with? This one and this one. This is an indoor wheel.
This is an indoor and this is an outdoor.
Right.
Okay.
And we had last year 100,000 people injured in roller skating accidents. 100,000. And people were reading about this all over in the newspaper, and they said, oh, gee, this is just like skateboarding. Wrong. It's not like skateboarding. The problem was that people were not getting proper instruction. They'd get on a pair of skates without knowing what to do. They would buy the wrong type of skates, and that pamphlet there that was printed by the Roller Skating Rink Operators Association, also the Sure Grip Skate Company, tells the people what to look for as far as buying skates. It also shows them some
where to skate, how to start, how to stop, how to buy, what to look for, and all those things.
If you buy a pair of rink skates, too, you're going to find one of those in every pair of skates that
comes
out. So.
This is an interesting skate here. We'll show you, then we'll go down and do our little demonstration. This is actually a shoe that has been converted to skates. Isn't that silly? Can you really skate with this?
You can skate forward for the most part. Quite a few people saw that on a TV show.
Forward,
while
you stop and turn sideways, huh?
But those were designed for those stores that don't allow roller skating, and you can pop those. And we sell those for $25, kind of an unusual gift.
What's the most expensive skate you can get?
Most expensive skate is made by the Snyder Skate Company, and that's that one right
this
there.
This is the plate right here. This plate, the wheels and stuff, without the boot, sells for what?
$300. They have one out now that'll be almost $500. So with the boots, you could bring that skate up to about $700.
Now, my boots are about $60-$70. Yours are these, so you've got $700 boots. Let's see who can skate the best. Come on.
You got
all right, are you ready for this? Oh, gosh, I forgot we have an edge here. Let me get right down here. Help. See, I'm real good at this, aren't I?
That's right. You had lessons from the best. Who'd you have lessons from?
You. Here, hold that now. Let's see the drop test.
Okay.
This is how to pick the wheels that you're going to get for inside or outside.
Now, you can see this is an outdoor wheel here.
Just by the color, you can tell.
No.
Oh, the way it bounces.
By the way it bounces. This has a lot of rebound to it, and that's what the wheels are measured by.
Now, the wheels that I have on and the wheels that you have on are indoor wheels.
Correct.
Okay.
All right, so we take this wheel, and we can
sort of like me when I fall.
You can see that when people go to buy wheels, that's one of the tests we usually have them do is bounce the wheel, and because a lot of times companies will misrepresent and say this is an indoor-outdoor. Don't listen to that.
There's an indoor and there's an outdoor. In 2 minutes, we're going to give you the basics of learning how to skate. Show me all the things real quick.
First of all, for let's say just skating forward, what we recommend, tell the people we have them bend their knees.
Okay,
keep the weight slightly forward.
All right, like skiing.
If you can't skate, use what's called a scissor movement, moving the feet out and in. And if you're going to learn to skate backwards, you can do the same thing out and in, called scissors. More importantly, Bob.
William. Okay.
More importantly is stopping. We recommend the toe stop, which is skating. Stand on your strong leg. Let the weight of your leg and the toe stop rest on the floor as you're going forward, and that'll
just drag a wheel right behind you. Drag the stop thing.
For the advanced people like you, you can use the.
I nearly tripped doing that. Are you kidding me?
You can use the T stop, and this is probably the most effective way, making your feet into an alphabet letter T.
But the thing that I keep wanting to do is stop as I do on skates. You know, come in into that number.
Skis, you mean, as you come up there.
Yeah, skis, yeah.
Skis, yeah. Well, you can do hockey stops
and
snow plows, sure.
Well,
I'll tell you. People should go to their local skating rink, get skating instruction, proper instruction, whether it's for an adult or for a child. Learn to skate properly.
Do you need the hand guards, the knee guards, the shoulder guards?
For outdoor skating, definitely. Wear wrist guards. The people that are becoming injured, those people are the ones that are going out there and thinking they can do it when they haven't skated for 20 years. Get the pamphlet. That'll help.
This really is. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob.
Skateland.
Thank you.
And people, you can look in your yellow pages and find out where the skating rinks are in your neighborhood that give instructions and stuff. You recommend that's the most important thing. Take lessons.
Take lessons. Come out and see us, Northridge.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Mike Fleming.
Thank you.
And in just a moment, we're going to find out a very interesting lady, and Meredith will be here with that.
We picked up your title going on throughout the United States through this evening and tomorrow. I'm going to be back on in the morning and near the end of your program. That's a promise. Our goal is $150,000, and I know we're going to bring it.
You're going to bring it?
Going to bring it with me.
Whenever you get here, there'll be no trouble getting in, I promise you.
Okay, that's good to hear.
Thank you, Bert.
Thank you, Jerry.
On behalf of my kids and everybody, thank you. And thank all the skaters, too. Okay. Now, I'm not going to introduce this performer until we've got the audience settled, because you don't introduce a performer like this.
On skates? There's a new kind of platform shoe. What's your name?
Allison.
Allison what?
Allison Edgerton.
Allison Edgerton. Hi, what's your name?
Mary Coyle.
Mary Coyle.
Al Hamlin.
Al Hamlin.
Mike Fleming.
And Mike Fleming. How about that? A handsome looking bunch of skaters. Oh, you're not on skates.
Not today, no.
Okay, what have you got there, Allison?
By the way, we have 3,000 more on the way by the end of next week, so that'll make a grand total of $7,400.
Did you get that? 3,000 more on the way. I can't thank you enough. Thank you very much. Okay. Hey, you going to skate out of here? How are you going to get by here? Okay. How about that, boy? That's 4,400 already collected and 3,000 more on the way. Hi, what's your name?
Rhonda Gans.
Ronnie?
Rhonda Gans.
Association, they're Mike and Darcy Fleming. And they have a little announcement.
The pledges that have been collected by the roller skaters across America.
You know, Jerry and Ed, it's because of your guidance and encouragement the roller skaters have been stimulated more than ever to do their thing for MD. Roller skaters across the country collected pledges from friends and acquaintances and then participated in skate-a-thons at local rinks in order to earn donations. Many of them skated 10, 15, 20 hours straight to earn the maximum pledge that they could get to turn into muscular dystrophy. And now, I guess we'll say the magic numbers,
Here we go. What is that?
The last total reported from the roller rinks across the country was $381,000.
How's that, gang?
Okay.
$381,000. Beautiful.
Since that time,
Yes.
The eastern area has reported pledges amounting to $28,000. So that brings the total of roller skating pledges up to a current total of $409,000.
$409,000, we accept. Thank you very much.
I'll tell you, we're halfway there to $1 million, and I'll tell you, we're sure going to try to reach it.
And you're rolling very nicely. That'll add to our mid-evening totals here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Darcy. Bye-bye. See you a little later. Okay, we are rolling along, and I think we might take a look at the tote board because Jerry mentioned before the fact that...
Thank you. 855-856-901 and